Welcome to the lecture series of Z transforms and difference equation. This is the next topic we are going to have the lectures. So the first we can see the definition for Z transforms. Let f of n be a sequence defined for n equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 etc. Then Z transform is defined as Z of f of n equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity f of n z power minus n, which is equal to function of z. This is called two-sided or bilateral z transform. So under the definition of z transform, what is a z transform is we can take any sequence. So sequence denoted by the bracket, chain bracket. So this is this one we have to read it as sequence. So sequence f of n. So z transform operates on sequence. So z of f of n equal to, here the limit is minus infinity to plus infinity. That is why it is called as two-sided. If suppose the limit is 0 to infinity, then it is called it as one-sided. That is what the next definition. Z of f of n equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity f of n z power minus n, which is equal to function of z. Here the limit is 0 to infinity. That is the reason why which is called as one-sided z transform. In the whole unit, we are going to use only one-sided z transform, that is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity only. And the next one is z transform for discrete values of t. When t comes, how we can apply the z transform. So look at this. If f of t is defined for discrete values of t, where small t equal to n capital T, where n takes a value 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Capital T be the sampling period, then z of f of t equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity f of n t z power minus n, which is also equal to f of z, function of z. So in this whole unit, wherever if t comes, instead of t we have to replace by n capital T. That capital T denotes for the sampling period. So when we are operating z transform on f of t, the definition becomes as 0 to infinity f of n t z power minus n. That means in the place of small t, we are replacing small n capital T, which is also the result of z, that is equal to function of z. This is the basic definition under z transform. Now we'll see a first very basic problem. Find z transform of 1. So first we apply the definition. We know that z of f of n equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity f of n z power minus n. Here f of n is nothing but 1. So we'll write that z of 1 is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity 1 z power minus n. So which is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity. We can write this z power minus n can be written as 1 by z power n. Now we are going to apply the values for n. When we are applying n equal to 0, 1 by z power 0. Anything power 0 is 1. So 1 plus n equal to 1. So 1 by z plus n equal to 2. 1 by z square plus 1 by z cube plus etc. It will go up to infinity. Now what we are going to do is, we have a very well known result, that is well known formula. 1 minus x whole power minus 1. What is the result? Result is 1 plus x plus x square plus etc. Such that mod x less than 1. This is the condition for applying the formula. So now we are comparing these two results. So when you are comparing this, in the place of x, here we are having 1 by z. So x is equal to 1 by z. So mod x less than 1. By the same manner, here 1 by z less than 1. That is the condition. So instead of this 1 plus 1 by z plus 1 by z square etc., we can replace the formula. So what is the formula? 1 minus x is equal to 1 by z. So 1 minus 1 by z whole power minus 1, such that mod x less than 1. So modulus of 1 by z less than 1. So minus 1 no, power minus 1 can be written as 1 by 1 minus 1 by z. So this can be take z minus 1. So 1 by z minus 1 by z, which is equal to z by z minus 1, such that 1 by z less than 1. So what is our left hand side? Left hand side is z transform of 1. So therefore z transform of 1 is equal to z by z minus 1. So this is what the required answer. Now look at the next question. Find z of n. So by the previous problem, by the same manner, z of f of n equal to definition of z transform. N equal to 0 to infinity, f of n, z power minus n. Now given f of n is n. So z of n is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity, f of n is n. So n into z power minus n. So this can be written as sigma n equal to 0 to infinity, n by z power n. So now we are going to give the values for n when n equal to 0. Okay, n equal to 0, anything by 0. Z power 0, anything by anything power 0 is 1, and the next one is 0 first, 0 by anything 0. So the first n equal 0, it takes 0, so no need to write that. Then n equal to 1, so 1 by z. When n equal to 1, we are getting 1 by z. Then n equal to 2, so 2 by z square. Then n equal to 3, so 3 by z cube plus etc. Now we can have the result. What is that result? 1 minus x power minus 2. So what is that formula? 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus etc. Condition is if mod x less than 1. This is what the formula. So by the same manner here we can compare these two results. But in the first place of the formula we have number 1. But here we are having the first place is 1 by z. This place should become as 1 means we have to take the 1 by z commonly outside from all the terms. So if you are taking 1 by z outside, what will happen? 1 plus 2 by z plus 3 by z square plus etc. Now we can easily compare this result with the formula. This is also similar to the formula. In the place of x, we are having 1 by z. So our condition is modulus of 1 by z less than 1. That is what, in the place of x we are having 1 by z. So obviously the mod x less than 1. Instead of that we can write it as modulus of 1 by z less than 1. And this also can be written as 1 by mod z is less than 1, which implies 1 is less than mod z. That means mod z is greater than 1. This is also we can write. So we can apply the result here. It is equal to 1 by z into 1 minus 1 by z whole power minus 2. By this result we can write this one as like this. Now this minus 2, no, so that one can be written as 1 by 1 minus 1 by z whole square. Now this can be written as 1 by z into 1 by z minus 1 by z whole square. That is equal to 1 by z, can bring this z into the numerator. So z square by z minus 1 the whole square. We can cancel the z and the square. So which is equal to z by z minus 1 the whole square. What is our left hand side? Left hand side is z of n. Therefore z of n is equal to z by z minus 1 the whole square. So this is what the answer for z transform of n. So all the basic results, z of 1, z of n, these are all becomes as a result in the big questions. So we have to remember all the problems, we are doing the basic things, that will become a part of your big questions. Thank you for watching.